Hey queens, I know we are all excited about the change in seasons. Bye-bye to the heat, y'all. Listen, I need you to go to www.thejoyamore.com. As we transition into the seasons, I want you to only be falling for one thing, and that is to fall in love with you. Use code FALL to save 15%. Love you. Hey queens, I know we are all excited about the change in seasons. Bye-bye to the heat, y'all. Listen, I need you to go to www.thejoyamore.com. As we transition into the seasons, I want you to only be falling for one thing, and that is to fall in love with you. Use code FALL to save 15%. Love you. Hello, everybody. Welcome.
Trying to wave. Hey, everybody.
What is today? Wednesday. Happy hump day, everybody. We made it this far into the week. Hello, everyone.
Wednesday the 21st. How many days till the election day?
We have made it. Today is hump day. We have made it this far into the week. Pat yourself on the back because you have done it through it all. No matter what you've gone through up until this moment, no matter what your week has been, your month has been, your 2020 has been, you have made it.
Only 13 days away to the election.
Pat yourself on the back. You have made it. No matter what you've gone through thus far, I'm going to say it a couple more times for those of you who need to hear it. Welcome. Hello. Hello. Are you here? Can you hear me?
Yo,
come on in the room.
Can you see the comments?
Mm-mm. Let me go back and see. Nope, can't see any comments.
Hello. Lots of people coming in saying hello.
Hello, everyone. Hello, welcome. Listen, don't forget to make sure that you like, okay? Hit the share button. Hello, queen. Mwah. Hello, all of my beautiful queens. How are you doing? Where are my comments? I can't see no comments.
There you go.
Hello.
The comments right there?
There we go. Hello, everyone. Hello, Miss B. Miss B, I've been missing you. Where you been? Hey, Robin. Hello, Sana. Hello, Missy. Hello, Tam. Hello, Tam. Thank you so much. You know what I do? I look cute. Listen, you guys, right now, www.thejoyamore. Go get your queen shirts. This is the long sleeve tee. It's almost like a sweatshirt, but not too heavy. I'm down here in Florida. Of course, you know, I had to let these shoulders out. But let me step back. Let me see. Excuse me. Can you go this way? Okay. Let me just step back so you can see what we got going on.
Tilt it up a little bit, maybe.
No, it needs to tilt down.
Okay.
Listen, it's what? Period. Right? Go get your shirts. Go get your long sleeve tees. All of that, 100%. This is what we got. This is what God has given us to work with. So that way we are queens, right? You are a queen. If I'm a queen, girl, you know you's a queen. Lady Luck, hello. Sharon Brooks, hello. Too cute. Hey, babe. Sharon, Shay, Deborah, Miss Sheila, Miss Snow, hello. The Elliott family, hello, Elliott family. Lady Luck, Ronnie. Vicky, hello. Gloria, hello. Tammy, hello. Yes, Debbie, you can email me privately. Don't abuse it, girl, but you definitely can email me. I'm here for you. Angela, hello. Kenya, hello. Hello. Wanda, what's going on, Miss Wanda? What's going on with your pretty self? Ronnie, you are right on time. You are not late at all. What's going on, everybody? Toya.
Where's everyone from?
Eric, no, Aricia. Is it Aricia? Shawana, hello. Hello, everyone. Welcome. Listen, like I said, today is Wednesday. It is hump day. Listen, positive vibes all day, every day. Listen, we have made it this far. Thus far, we have made it. And no matter what it is, listen, I came here to tell you really quick. Let me go ahead and give you the word of the day. Y'all like my wig?
I was gonna ask you about your wig.
No.
No, nothing.
Let me go ahead and give you your word of the day. Okay. Hello, Lillian. Yes, let me know where everyone is from. Can everyone please put in the comments where you're from? Please, ladies, as you come in, can you please hit the like button and also hit the share? Hello, Monet. Monet, what's going on?
Mardi Gras, is that in Mobile, Alabama, or is that New Orleans?
It's Mardi in New Gras. Orleans. Yeah. So
we got someone there from Mobile, Alabama. Mardi Gras.
Mardi Gras is not in Alabama, Chris.
I know. They're from Alabama.
Welcome, everyone. Listen, really quick. Let me give you your word. Listen. I know that you have a dream, right? And I know that you have done the same thing I did, right? I sometimes have been guilty. You guys continue to put where you're from in the comments. I want to know exactly where you're from. And I'm going to shout out your cities in a minute, okay? We're going to cook tonight, but we're going to spend the first 15 minutes getting our mind right, right? Because see, what happens to us is that throughout our day, what happens is that we wake up with determined. We wake up with something on our mind and says, okay, I'm going to get things done today. But in the process of trying to get things done, what happens is negativity comes, right? Because listen, remember how they used to say, be careful little eyes what you see, be careful little ears what you hear. Sometimes we let the wrong thing and the wrong people in our spirit. And let me tell you something that I've made a mistake of, okay, y'all? Please excuse me, I'm trying to get the camera right. Y'all know we on a budget. So our production is on a budget, girl. So what happens to us is that, and this is something I'm very guilty of, we get excited in the beginning about our dreams and about our visions, right? We get very excited because we're thinking that those dreams and those visions are going to come to pass. But then we make the mistake of telling the wrong person about our dreams and our visions. And that person, see, they don't have a dream or a vision. They dream and they vision have died. So they don't want to see you with your dream or your vision. So what ends up happening is your dream and your vision dies because you done told the wrong person. And the next thing you look around, your vision is dead, but that person is walking around living your vision. Number one, you have to live your vision, yes. But sometimes we cannot share our vision. We have to keep our vision to ourselves. I know this is for somebody. I don't know who this is for, but this is what's on my spirit. Don't give up on your vision. Just because you told someone something and they told you 125 ways of how you couldn't do it, don't give up on your vision. I'm fat, morbidly obese. I'm black. Don't got a mama. Don't got a daddy. Don't have no family. I'm by myself. Struggling, trying to go to school, get my education. I'm 32 years old, trying to get a master's degree. Everybody in my family graduated from college at 25. That's not my story, right? I'm working full-time, trying to... How dare I have the audacity? Who wants to see my fat black self? Who? With a white man. Who wants to see me? How dare I call myself a queen? How dare I? The audacity of me, right? To try to come and uplift someone else when I should just go hide underneath the counter on the floor because I ain't nothing. I ain't never been nothing. I'm never going to be nothing. How dare I? Who wants to watch my fat black self? Don't nobody want to watch me. I can't dress. I'm telling you all the things that people will tell you. Because, see, what happens is they see your vision and they're afraid of you. It's that Joseph story. It's a Joseph situation. Who else on here is Joseph? Who else is Joseph? See, this is a Joseph situation. When you have a dream and God give you a dream and he say to you, listen, people are going to bow down before you. Joseph, Joseph, are you listening to me? Joseph, I'm talking to you, Joseph. Who is Joseph? Who am I talking to? Who am I talking to? Who is this for today? Who is this for? Hey, bestie. Joseph, listen to me, Joseph. You have a dream and you done messed around and told these hating ass people that's around you your dream. Right, Joseph? We are Joseph, bestie. We are Joseph. I'm Joseph. You, Joseph. All of those who've had a dream. God gave Joseph a dream that his family members would bow before him. Like the moon and the stars. Read your word, girl. That's in the word. Right? Joseph. Hello, Joseph. And what they did, they plotted because Joseph was already blessed. Joseph came from Rachel, which was the only woman that they daddy loved. So they was already hating on Joseph, but from the start, before he even came about, they was already hating on him because his daddy loved him. You are Joseph. People hating on you for no reason. You ain't did nothing to these people. You ain't did nothing with these people. What have you done to people but live your best life? You ain't did nothing to nobody, girl. Stop beating yourself over your head because you woke up and had a dream. God gave you your dream, and it's people that's waiting on you to get your shit together because you're their deliverance. But you so worried about the next person and them talking about you. Girl. Let it go. You have a dream. Pursue your dream. And be careful who you tell your dream to. And don't let nobody interrupt you and your dream. That's your word for today. Resurrect your dream. Your dream is not dead. Your dreams are not dead. It's never too late. Whatever it is, listen, queen. Period. Whatever your dream is, walk into your dream today. Get yourself together. Girl, get it together. Whatever it is you need to do, get it together. It's not going to be easy. But girl, you done been through worse than that before. Don't let nobody steal your dream. Your dream is not dead. I don't care if it's a business, to go to school, to walk out in your calling. No matter what it is, be quiet. Keep your mouth closed. Your ears open and your eyes open, period. Get yourself together. Period. Get yourself together, girl, and get your dream written down. We're going to do our vision board. Y'all done came and gave y'all a 15-minute word, so all the haters done logged off. I ain't worried about it. You don't have to watch me because I'm going to tell you what, Joseph. Your dream ain't dead, girl. You've been through worse. This ain't the worst you've been through. You can make it one more day. Get yourself together. Thank you, Silk. Get yourself together, girl. You've been through worse. Now listen, let's cook this chicken. Listen, y'all, real quick. Don't forget, go www. Help me live my dream, girl. That's so petty. www.thejoyandmore.com, our queendom shirts, hoodies. We're getting those back in stock. We're still going to be doing a giveaway. Make sure when this live is over that you girls come back and comment on the live and let me know, do you guys want me to keep doing homework or housekeeping? We have two shows this week. We have a lingerie haul. Lord Jesus, God help us all. Girl, these people don't convince me. But listen, this lingerie haul is for all you fat girls who had a dream and they told you that you weren't going to be nothing and that your dream wouldn't make it, this is for you. I'm doing this for you. Then we got a Curb Girl try on haul too, which is some really cute things, okay? So y'all be on the lookout for that. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video if you are watching. Oh, I'm so glad, Shonda. Yes, get your shirt, girl. Queen, period. www.djoyamore.com. Listen, if you're watching on Facebook, head on over to YouTube and make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. My name is Joy Moore. I would love to be in your life, right? Because I'm going to always make sure that I'm uplifting you and encouraging you. Girl, we're going through a lot of things together. Y'all know when we get to this time of year, we got to push a little bit harder. We got to push a little bit harder to get us through the end of the year, girl. Because it'd be a lot. It's a lot, girl. It's coming up on the first of the month. We're trying to pay these bills. We behind. We got a lot going on. It's a whole bunch of people telling us how we not going to make it. But Joseph, listen to me. Joseph, listen to me. Your dream ain't gone, Joseph. Go get your dream, babe. Yes, look, I had to make it off the shoulder. Yes, I had to cut it off the shoulder. This is the long sleeve tee. Y'all, listen. Okay, what we're going to cook today, I don't want us eating too late because we're going to start paying attention to what we eat and how we eat. We're going to do some smothered chicken. We're going to do some green beans, and I'm doing cabbage again, y'all. I love cabbage. I'm Jamaican. It is what it is. I will eat cabbage every day if I have to eat cabbage every day. Listen, Joseph, come forth in your ministry, Joseph. Your dream ain't dead, girl. I'm going to keep telling you that all tonight. Your dream is not dead, period. No matter what, so no matter how somebody else hating ass and told you how you won't be nothing, Joseph, you're going to be everything. Everything you want to be, you're going to be. This is not going to let trouble don't last always, girl. You're going to make it. Do you hear me? You're going to make it. Hold your head up high. Go on, get in that bathtub and wash your ass. Light you a candle. Because, you know, listen, relax, wash your ass. Ain't nothing you can do about what's going on tonight. You can't do nothing about it. Ain't nothing you can do about it tonight. Go on in there, wash your ass, get you a candle, light you a candle, relax, play you some music. It don't have to be gospel. Okay? Go on, get your ass in there and relax. And give it to the Lord. There's a couple of areas in your life that ain't quite right that you need to get in line. Once you get them in line, everything is going to be okay. But what you're not going to do is shrivel up and die and give up on your dream. Because this right here is it's like a muscle, baby. We flexing our muscles. We working our muscles out. Faith is a muscle, girl. You got to work that faith muscle out, queen. Come on, queen. What's up? This is not it. Joseph, do you hear me? This is not it. I know these hoes trying to throw you in the cave, girl. They done went and lied and said you was dead, said you done fell off, said you shooting bad, said your hair ain't done, said your house is dirty, said you ain't got no car, you dirty foot, you got all these kids, right? They done lied and talked about you. But that's okay, because that makes it all the better. But when you come back on these hoes, better than ever before, because trust me, they will come back around again. They're going to come back again. They're going to see you. You don't have to have no vengeance. You don't have to take nothing out on nobody, because they will see you again. And the next time a hoe see you, they're going to see you doing good. Period. Now, I'm done with that. Now, let's have some fun. Listen, y'all know that I have been on a weight loss journey for a very long time. I have worked really, really tediously to try to lose some weight, girl. I lost about 130 to 140 pounds. Since February, y'all, I'm being honest with y'all, I have gained 40 pounds. Okay, I've been gaining some weight. I know when you super big, it seemed like it don't matter, but y'all listen, as you can see, I'm getting several chins. That's not gonna work, girl. That's not cute. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna work our way into trying to eat better. Now, y'all know I told y'all about Dax, D-A-K-S, DaxSpices.com. I need y'all to go. Yes, 1960s girl. Wait, hold on.
Here's some Dax.
Yes, Dax, y'all. I love my Dax seasoning. Now, this, I don't know. I got to go on the website. One of my favorites, Dax seasoning, is Steakhouse. It's like a Montreal steak seasoning. It's a very good seasoning. So Steakhouse is one of my favorite. They have a good Italian seasoning that I absolutely love. One of the things that they have that's seasonal, I don't know if they have it this year. I got to go on their website. But pumpkin spice, listen, it don't have no salt, no MSG. If you got high blood pressure, girl, if your feet is swole, don't be walking around with no swole feet. Yes, Ronnie, you use Dax. Dax is the best season. Now, I know y'all like Mrs. Dash and Flavor God and all of that. Girl, no. Go to DaxSpices.com. Dax, okay? Y'all, what I'm going to do is we're going to be talking about different items that we can use that we can do better with our eating. Because it's a gradual journey, and we all on that journey to do a little bit better. Now, listen, y'all, I'm going to be cutting some of these carbs. But tonight ain't going to be the night to cut nothing, girl. Because I ain't going to cut nothing, but I'm going to cut up. But I'm definitely going to use my Dax seasoning. My favorite, like I said, is the Original Red. Just think Original Red seasoning is like seasonal without the salt. So y'all head on over to DaxSpices.com, okay, and get y'all. Ronnie, you get yours from Amazon? You buy it in bulk? Thank you, Ginger Snaps. Welcome. Listen, if you are new and you don't know me, I would love to get to know you. I would love if you subscribe to my channel. Girl, we have a good time over here, as you can see. Sometimes it just be on me, and I have to tell the people what was told to me, and I have to talk to my other Joseph, because I know I'm not the only Joseph here, right? That's okay, Eleanor. We're going to work on motivation, girl. We're going to motivate each other. Okay, but y'all listen, don't forget, y'all go get y'all queen shirts to remind yourself you all queens. What are you doing?
Chicken.
We're not eating that tonight.
Well, not this, but I'm just saying you're throwing stuff that you used on your diet.
Right, but I'm just showing them the Dax spices. Okay. Because I use a lot of Dax spices, okay?
Yeah,
I love you, Missy Dixon. Listen, okay, y'all, don't forget to like and share. Like and share. If you're watching me on Facebook, get on over here on YouTube, Joy Amore. Hey, Lavetta. Lavetta Luckett, what bad food am I eating, my love? Do you know exactly what my diet is? I would ask that you please don't read me, read your Bible. Okay? Don't read me, read your Bible. You understand? Don't read me, girl. Read your Bible. But let me help you. There you go, Lavetta. Let me help you. You go in peace, my love. Hey, Rose, what's going on, Golden? Yes, staying in the house, yes. What my bestie said. Listen, because I know right now we got to push. And I want to cook so bad, y'all. I didn't feel like coming on here doing all this talking. We got to push a little harder right now. Thank you, Lee. Okay, y'all, so let's go ahead and get cooking. So let's cook this chicken. We're going to prepare the chicken. Now, I did a lot of prep work. Because, y'all, I'm going to try to be out of here by 10 o'clock. Who going to be my minute keeper? Hey, studio. What's going on, babe? Who going to be my minute keeper? Who going to keep minutes and let me know what time it is, y'all? I need to get off of here by 10 o'clock, y'all. What's going on, Sharon? Yeah, let's get it. Okay. Babe, put that coffee down. What you doing? Did you say hey to people?
Yeah, I did. I said hello and I was waving them both hands.
I wasn't paying you no attention. I had to get
these.
Yeah, I had to tell these people. I had to talk to my Joseph.
That's why I had to step away from the call Joseph.
Yeah, I had to talk to my Joseph. I had to because...
And it's good. I'm glad you did. I saw people really appreciated it.
No, and I didn't even get to see the comments, and I'm sorry if I didn't get to respond.
Well, that's another reason why we prepped the food tonight, so we'd have more time.
That we'll have more time to just talk with you guys. I love you guys to the moon and back. If you ever felt like you didn't have love or you didn't have the support that you needed, I love you guys. So listen, it's a couple hundred people on here, so I'm hoping that we will have a... several hundred likes and shares and such. Let's get into it. What's going on, Godiva? I love me some Godiva. What's going on, Godiva? If there was a name that I could have, it would be Godiva. Okay, so let's go ahead.
What are you doing first? What's first?
First, I want to go ahead and let's, I need that big pot. I'm going to do two pots at a time.
Okay. Need the big red pot?
Yeah. Is it clean? You don't wash it out?
Yeah, I got this pot. I got the one in the dishwasher. It's clean. This pot.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and let's put we'll put this one here. And so we prepped a little bit early tonight, y'all. So I cut us up some green beans. So we're gonna do some green beans and some potatoes. Okay, so we're gonna do some green beans and a little bit of potatoes and some cabbage. And I'm gonna make some smothered chicken, girl. We're gonna smother and cover it in all this love, girl. It's gonna be thick like me.
Got the onions and the potatoes.
Yeah, so I went ahead and I cut. See, I've been working for y'all today. I cut up my onions and I cut up some potatoes. I'm just gonna put, listen, this is like one.
Little red potatoes.
Little red potatoes. It's like, this is like one or two little potatoes, y'all. But okay, so. Get
the cabbage already sliced.
Yep, and we got cabbage left over as well.
Chicken tenders.
And then here go the chicken. I'm gonna go ahead and season it and get stuff started. So let me go ahead and get these pots rattling, okay?
Good to me.
All right,
there you go.
I'm gonna go ahead and put some butter in here and some garlic.
You need thick butter or you want the fake butter? It's butter.
I'm cheating tonight, y'all. I'm using this some garlic. Bay accidentally, what's going on?
I can't believe it's butter.
Yes, dust on my shoe. Listen, that's biblical. That's what the Bible say. Like dust. Dust under your feet. Dusty hoes. Listen, these hoes is dusty. Babe, get my glasses, because I'm squinting. You see me squinting? I'm squinting so hard.
What, the thin ones or the other ones?
Huh?
Which ones?
Whatever you get to first. That's clean. Hold on just a second, Eleanor, and I got you, girl. We're going to use some light olive oil. I can't believe it's not butter. They clean.
Yeah, one of your desk. Probably still hot. I don't want to burn the butter.
Yeah, turn it down.
Here's your glasses.
Thank you, honey.
You bring the camera over here to see them cooking.
Right, honestly, I think we should be good.
Okay. Bring it over, it's
portable.
Garlic together. Yeah. Garlic and butter.
Go ahead and put some.
Do the onions, the potatoes.
Put these onions in here. Let me talk to my baby. What's she said? No, let me talk to her. See what she's talking about. Girl, I'm 25 years old. Girl, I had to put my glasses on so I can see, mama. I study at Harvard University. I major in psychiatry, and I'm in the process of registry. Good job.
Harvard?
I can't seem to get motivated since it's my last year. My tip to you... is that what happens to us is that, because I go through this a lot. when you are a goal setter, when you are a type of person who works towards achieving goals, what happens is you have the carrot. You know how they dangle the carrot? You have a carrot dangling in front of you, okay? Right? And you think to yourself, okay, I'm going to lose this 200 pounds. Like, let me just give you an example. I'm going to lose this 200 pounds. When I lose, look, unsalted cooking stock. When I lose this 200 pounds, everything going to be right. And then what happens is when you start and you don't lose 199 pounds, and you feel like your life is not where you want it to be, you find something else to focus on. And now it's like, okay, I lost 200 pounds, now what? Do you see what I'm saying? So when you got to think of it like this. What's going on, nurse? How you doing, babe? What's going on, Janice? You have to think about it like this, okay? You can do it, and you will do it, and you are doing it. But you have to look for the long-term feelings of satisfaction. Let me give you an example. For me, I have core things that it takes to make me feel satisfied. And some of those core things are, number one, I have to have a feeling of security and safety. If I don't have a feeling of security and safety, I'm going to feel dissatisfied in my life, no matter what's going on in my life. If something is making me feel insecure and I don't feel safe, I'm not going to be happy. If something is making me feel like I'm not progressing, like I can't stand to be stagnant. If I feel stagnant, I don't care if I got $1 million in the bank, I'm not going to be happy. Do you see what I'm saying? For Chris, if he's not networking and he's not communicating with people, that satisfies a core need in him. See, me, I don't have to necessarily be communicating with people. As long as I have a sense of security, I feel like I'm making progress, I feel like I'm fulfilling my goals, then I'm okay. You see what I'm saying? So I said all that to say is you got to find what is it that you were looking to gain from graduating from school. There's some type of core need that you were looking to feel fulfilled on your journey that you feel like you're close to it now, but you still don't feel fulfilled. That's why you're lacking motivation. So you got to hit the reset button. Okay. Everything that you've done up until this point, you deserve it. It's in your reach. You're going to have it, but we got to hit the reset button and we have to start over. That's why, even though it's not New Year's, a lot of people, like, for example, I put up the other day, I was like, hey, who's going to come with me and make a vision board? Somebody was like, it's not January. You don't need to make a vision board unless it's the new year. I said, okay, boo, you don't have to make no vision board. That's fine, girl. That's fine, boo. I'll make my vision board in peace. You understand what I'm saying? What's up, Rachel? I love you too, queen. Thank you for being here. But can you go put the air down? I'm a little hot. I hope I'm making sense, and I hope that helps to kind of give you an idea of what I mean. Thank you, man. It's hot.
Yeah. In the other room, blowing the hot air out.
I'm gonna put all this in and then
saving up onion, babe. When you get a chance, I need you to cut this other onion up for me.
Okay.
And put butter in everything, because I need butter in the cabinet and butter in here. You know where my top of this is?
Where do we put it?
I don't know.
Here it is.
Let me go ahead and... Hold on, y'all. I'm coming. I got to get the seasoning because I'm on a time crunch. I got to do better than what I've been doing lately. So I can sit down and we can talk.
Are you
going to wash the chicken?
Yeah, it's done. Already, it's all prepped.
Wait, I need that other. That ain't gonna work.
What?
I need the other. That I need the fan to face the other way.
Oh, okay.
Oh my God.
What's going on?
Thank you so much, my queens. Oh my God, I didn't even notice. What's going on, Biggs? Thank you so much, Rose. Please keep me updated with the time. Keep me up with the time, boo, please. Thank you, Queen. Oh, my God, y'all, I didn't even see this. Thank you, Sharon. Put the chicken in there. Make sure it's like...
Chicken and the onions?
Huh?
Chicken in here with the onions?
Yes. Thank you, Sharon. Oh, my God, I didn't even see that. You guys was blessing me. I'm so sorry. Rachel, thank you so much, Rachel T. God bless you. Who's Scar? Is it Scariel? Who's Scariel? Is that who it is? Hi, Stephanie. Yeah, so let's have a vision party, you guys. Let's get together and decide on what date. Hey, bro, what's going on, Biggs? Let's decide on what day we're going to get together and let's do our vision boards, y'all. So we can work. We don't need to wait until December and January to reset. Because it's not, listen, y'all, I'm telling y'all, it's not over. We just getting started, okay? Thank you so much for all of you who gave me super stickers. Did I miss anybody? If I missed anyone, please let me know. If you sent cash apps or anything like that, you guys, please, don't ever think that I'm ignoring you, y'all. I'm just in here. This is a cooking show. It's cooking and conversations. We come here at least. Hey, Divas. We come here to cook together, to spend some time together, to talk, to grow together. That's okay, Janice. That's all right, Janice. We can work on it together. That's all right. Oh, Silk, you know what? I missed you. I'm so sorry. We'll be praying for you. So let's talk, y'all. What y'all want to talk about? Okay? Y'all let me know what y'all want to talk about, what we're going to talk about, what's the conversation about. I'm getting hot because I got these long sleeves on. I don't want to mess up my shirt. Y'all, don't forget, www.thejoyamore.com. Get your queen shirt. Yes. After show, listen, let me... Y'all, whatever I do makes people so mad. I don't know why. Let me make them mad. Hey, Karen. I know you watching. Shout out to Karen, y'all. Y'all say, hey, Karen. I couldn't help it. I had to do it. I know I was wrong, but I had to do it. Okay. Y'all, look. If I'm so fat and I'm so disgusting and I'm so bad-bodied and I'm a fetish, and Chris is only with me because I'm a fetish, then why are you so angry, girl? Why are you so mad, boo? Why are you so aggravated? Let me tell you something. The anointing destroys the yoke. Let me tell you something. I know that you want... I know... Let me just say this real quick. Y'all excuse me, please. Please excuse me. Y'all say, hey, Karen. Listen. I know that you over there digging as hard as you can, digging a ditch for me. I know you trying to dig a ditch for me, baby. But why are you doing all of that digging? Please make sure, my love, that you dig one for yourself. Because this that I have, no matter how much you try to copy me, you will never be me. God gave this to me. It's my gift. And you have a gift. And I beseech you, my love, beloved. I beseech you, beloved, to concentrate on discovering your gift. Because God says that the gift will make room for you. My gift made room for me, my love. And you cannot be me. So you can research all my videos. You can copy them word for word. You can steal my pictures. You can make posts about me. You can report my channel. You can hit the dislike button. Girl, you will never be me because you don't have my gift. God gave me this gift, and what he gave me, you can't take it away. Do you understand? Because it was given to me. You will never be me, my love. Beloved, I beseech you, discover who you are and what gifts that God have given to you so that way you can walk forth in your ministry. Because this is not where it's at. Do you understand? You can't make me upset. You can't make me angry. Yes, I'm fat. I'm black. Some may think I'm disgusting. I'm morbidly obese. Okay. And God's still blessing me, girl. And he's still with all of that. And he's still making a way for me, girl. What are you doing? With all of that.
Okay, let me hand me the season so I can season this chicken.
What are you seasoning? What seasoning?
So let's do a little bit of onion powder.
Onion powder.
Did you open it for me, boo?
No.
Can you open it for me? I just felt like talking today. They so mad. I don't know why.
Uh-huh.
Some onion powder. Let's do a little bit of garlic powder.
Garlic powder coming up. Here we go. It's open.
That's not garlic powder. I need garlic powder. Boo.
What is that?
Vanilla garlic powder.
Put that in front of
uh-uh. Let me get the Italian.
Where's your garlic powder? I don't see the garlic powder.
Look over there.
Oh,
it's real.
Here. No. Don't worry
about it.
Mm-hmm.
You might be gone. Seasoning. Yeah, black pepper. Yeah.
White pepper is open.
Let's get the
seasoning on food,
girl.
Okay, what next?
I'm gonna use a little bit more of this unsalted chicken stock. What's going on, Stephanie? Hello, everybody. If I haven't gotten a chance to say hello to you, hello, my love. I'm trying to get this cooking done.
I'm getting hungry.
Chris, you stay hungry.
I never miss a meal, do I?
No. let's find out in front of the people what we're talking about tonight.
Yeah, what are we talking about tonight? Where's my?
I done got off my soapbox and I finished all my preaching. Thank you, Sheila.
Oh. Well, let's see what's going on. Mm-hmm. I guess we're less than 2 weeks out from the election. I don't really want to talk about that. It's on 24/7. You got plenty of news channels playing, talking about the election. So that's coming right up. Got the, I guess, the last presidential debate coming up tomorrow night.
But people gonna tell you in the comments what they want to talk about.
Yeah, what do you want to talk about? Kind of lost.
Can you see in the comments?
Yeah, let me see.
Can you watch this? Hold on, y'all. I don't want to mess up my shirt. I'm gonna go change my shirt. What's up, studio? What's up, Chloe? What's going on, babe? I'm going to put something on there. Give me just a moment.
Oh, that's a good one from studio.
Yes, Divas. I don't understand it. You so mad at me, girl, but yeah, you stay trying to do what I do. You call what? I mean, you're calling. You are you really seriously calling brands to tell brands not to work with me, my love, beloved girl? Come on. And you think that makes you look bad? What I have, God didn't give it to you, but he might do. You have to give it some time. He blesses everybody. Don't be mad at me because of my blessing. Girl, what I got, you didn't give it to me. God gave it to me, girl. Come on now. Thank you, Randall. Thank you, Deborah. Well, I mean, okay, y'all, let me. Wait, it's on my back, y'all. Do I got some on my back? Babe, I got something in the back of my shirt. Y'all, I'm so scared. I don't want to mess up my queendom shirt. I mean, I think a little bit of fear of rejection is good for me. I think a little bit of a fear of rejection is good. I mean, I think that the number one thing is that you have to think about it in terms of what is for you is for you. Who you're supposed to be with, you will meet organically. So I think the number one thing to do is making sure that you yourself are a whole person. I recommend to anyone when you're dating, number one, heal your hurts. Heal the areas that you hurt. Hold on, y'all. I'll be right back. I'm hot. I got to get out this long sleeve. Hold on a minute. I'm hot and I don't want to mess up. Sure. I don't want to mess up my shirt. Okay. Okay. Are you taking it, boo? Who do me a favor? In the bathroom, it's some clips on the counter. Okay. Try and get me two of those.
Sure. Clips.
The clips, yeah. Okay, y'all, we doing this kitchen, this chicken down. Let's get this cabbage started. It won't take a minute, but a minute. Hold on, studio. I got you, boo. Give me 1 second. Who's my timekeeper? What we looking like on time?
We've been,
Don't
go too high.
Okay.
And then just twist it.
Okay.
And then put it on my head and
then put the clip.
Yeah. Okay.
Now
get
the other one.
Okay. Where does one go? Okay.
I'm coming, studio. I got you, girl. In just a minute. Where's my my red? I ain't got no more.
More what?
Paprika.
Yeah, paprika. We got more paprika.
Where my paprika at?
Should have been up there. It was all right there in that counter, but then I had to move stuff around. I don't know where we put it.
I just need a little bit of paprika.
I can't find it. I don't know what happened to it. It was up there. Here it is.
You got it. Put me some paprika in there. Thank you, honey.
In here?
Yeah. I'm turning it up so we can start sweating.
Okay, so we got everything on the stove now, looks like. We've got everything cooking. everything on here. We can just move everything over to the table. Huh?
Yeah.
Start moving the light and everything.
Studio, one of the most important things about being in love and about dating, in my opinion, is being a whole person. Before you can date somebody, you got to be a whole person. Because when you... No, go ahead. Leave it. I know. Well, why are you dating somebody when you're a whole person, okay? It will make sure that you're looking at that person from the right eyes. You don't want to see that person from a hurt place. And when you're afraid of a rejection, it's because you feel like you're going to be missing out or losing out on something if someone says that they don't want to be with you. But what about what they're missing out on? I mean, come on, you're a businesswoman. You know, is it an optometrist? Is that the correct one? You have your own practice. You're beautiful. You're independent. You're very kind, very loving. I mean, who wouldn't want to love you? So my advice to you is before you start dating, become a whole person. Make sure that you are concentrating on doing things that make you happy and being a whole person. Okay? Never settle. Stephanie Culberson got it right. Studio, you're beautiful. You do you. Be yourself. Love yourself, right? And the right guy will come along to you. Loving yourself is key to everything. Don't settle. You deserve the best, and you deserve to be treated like a queen. Yes. So don't concentrate on thinking like, you know, you're not the one that's missing out. If somebody doesn't want to be with you or they're rejecting you, it's because they don't deserve you, and maybe God sees something that you don't. These glasses are, what are they called? Swarovski. I get all of my glasses from my optometrist. His name is Dr. Hubble, and he's old as dirt. He's been old since I've been going to him, and I've been going to him for 20 years. So that should tell you how old he is. Miss Valita, there you go. That's your word right there. Y'all, I wish there was smell-o-vision. We got cabbage, we got green beans and potatoes, and we're going to smother us some chicken. Some boneless, skinless chicken tenderloins without the fat. Everybody love up on Studio. Let her know how much value she brings to the table. You guys, if you're not already, don't forget to go to my Patreon. Listen, we're gonna be watching a movie. If you are in my Patreon already, you guys, please make sure I'm gonna create a post either tonight or tomorrow, so that way we can decide what day we're gonna do it. But it's gonna be before the end of the month, and it's not gonna be the 31st. So between now and the 31st, we're gonna be having our pajama party. We're gonna do giveaways. I got so many giveaways for you guys. I went a little bit crazy. Don't judge me, but I cannot wait. So if you have not already, please go to patreon.com/joyamore so that way you can join in on the fun. The ladies inside the Patreon have decided that even though you may not be able to be eligible for gifts and prizes your first month in Patreon, because I have some queens that have been with me since day one, on our next, we do it every month. So on our next pajama party, you will be eligible to win gifts, okay? But I will have a little gift for you. You just, you know what I'm saying, not the big gifts, okay? So go to www.patreon.com/joyamore and join the Patreon, okay? And ladies, if you're already in Patreon, can you please let me know what movie we're going to watch? Hey, Shanita. Thank you, Tam. I love you. Right. Listen, have you ever dated somebody, right? And then y'all broke up for whatever reason, and you were heartbroken. And then you seen them years later, and you was like, what in the hell was I thinking? What happened? Listen, y'all love on Studio. Y'all encourage her, uplift her, love on her. Why you say that, Shanice? Yes, that's coming from a man, so believe it. Yes. What's burning? My God, today.
Come along, babe. Coming good?
Mm-hmm.
Can you come bring me the resin onion?
Yeah.
I need
some more. I want to put some more onion in here.
Put it in where? Which one?
In here.
I'm using a warped cutting board.
Oh, my cutting board warped?
Yeah.
Oh, Lord. Chris, you ain't have to tell all my business that my cutting board was toe up. I'm going to have to get another cutting board. Well, that's what Black Friday is for. I can't get no cutting board until on Black Friday. Y'all timekeepers, keep me in line. What time is it?
8:45.
Really? We doing good.
Yeah, we're not doing bad.
We're going to spend about 2 hours together tonight, y'all.
On.
I put it on, but babe, you know that burner. I don't know, that burner needs to be anointed because this is going through. You put me some paprika in there, babe?
Yeah,
put
paprika in there.
Babe, can you show them the chicken?
The chicken right here?
Mm-hmm. Be careful, it's hot. Y'all, the chicken, we about to make the gravy. It ain't got the gravy on it yet. But there goes some chicken. It's the tenderloin.
What you got in that chicken?
I got some onions in there. We got some seasoning in there, y'all. Y'all go on over there and get y'all some Dax Spices here. DaxSpices.com. No MSG, no sodium, none of that. We got some unsalted chicken stock. I don't like broth. I like the stock. We got some onion. We got chicken tenderloin because it's easier to deal with. There's no bone and all of that. And then we got some black pepper, onion powder.
That seasoning.
That's a piece of cabbage. I hate miscellaneous stuff. Why a piece of cabbage get in my chicken?
Pulling those onions.
But yeah, black pepper, all of that. Paprika seasoned real good. And then we're going to take us some cream of chicken soup, fat-free, low-sodium cream of chicken soup. Because you got to be careful with the condensed soup. It's got a lot of seasoning in it. And put it in there and make us a little bit of a smothering. Go ahead, babe, and then stir up the cabbage. The cabbage ain't done yet, though, y'all.
Now, how's the chicken pretty much done? I can put the beans on the back burner.
Okay. Yeah.
Chicken pretty well done.
Well, I'm going to have to put some fat-free cream of chicken soup.
Yeah, this front burner is going to keep it warm. It's not going to be able to boil it like this back burner will help us.
A lot of sodium in this doggone cream of chicken soup, but we're going to dilute it. Yes, Shanita, girl, come on. Wear your mask, girl. Wear your mask. What's going on, Cat and Candy? What's up, Arsh? I ain't see you, girl. What's going on, babe? Y'all, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, make sure that you share. When you share this and you like it, YouTube gets happy and they share it. So the more you share it, the more they share it. Y'all know how it go.
Over. It basically needs to boil for another, 15, 20 minutes?
Mm-hmm. I need
to boil. So, low commercial break, and I'll move everything over to the table.
You want me to go ahead and put the rest of that in here first.
The rest of the table.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
commercial and move everything over to the table.
Now, y'all that's been with me for a while, y'all know how I do my cabbage. Okay, so we got cabbage. Nice and seasoning. Y'all see how them speckles of seasoning? All of that. Look at it. So we're going to let that cabbage do what it do. Okay, so the cabbage is smelling nice and buttery. Here go the green beans with some onions and potatoes. Okay, they're getting ready. Okay,
man,
you want me to go to commercial?
Yeah, let's go to commercial.
Okay, y'all, we got to go to commercial break. Don't leave. Please stay. Make sure that you like, comment, and share. Much love to you, who's Scariel. I appreciate you, boo. Okay, y'all, hold on a minute. We're going to commercial. We'll be right back. Y'all don't go nowhere.
Hey queens, I know we are all excited about the change in seasons. Bye-bye to the heat, y'all. Listen, I need you to go to www.thejoyamore.com. As we transition into the seasons, I want you to only be falling for one thing, and that is to fall in love with you. Use code FALL to save 15%. Love you.
God.
Hey queens, I know we are all excited about the change in seasons. Bye-bye to the heat, y'all. Listen, I need you to go to www.thejoyamore.com. As we transition into the seasons, I want you to only be falling for one thing, and that is to fall in love with you. Use code FALL to save 15%. Love you.
I'll turn this thing off.
Now you, well, you can turn it on, just not directly on me.
Okay.
Like, that's good.
Better?
Yeah. And I need a laptop so I can see my comments.
We live now?
Yeah, we live. We came back. We back. You guys, what time is it?
8:54.
9 o'clock. What's up, Port Rhines? Arsh, I didn't know. Thank you, Miss Belita. We're not going to talk about that website here, please, if you don't mind. I'd appreciate it if we kind of don't talk about that. Thank you. What's going on, Mongolian Mahogany Hall? You, thank you so much for all of you who have supported me. What's going on, Carol? going on, my babies? Y'all had to put this wig up. I'm about to help. Y'all know I don't do well with wigs for a long period of time. No, it's okay, Canadians. Just that, you know, that's not something that I openly talk about on here. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Yep, I'm doing very well. God has blessed me with a very loyal and kind following. That's why I'm going to concentrate on those who love me and appreciate me. I'm not going to concentrate on those who mistreat me and, you know, don't act right and make fun of me and tell me how much, how ain't nobody going to want to watch me. Don't nobody want to watch me. Okay, girl. No, they don't want to watch me. Okay. Okay, girl. Thank you, Arch. Dee Dee, you can go to www.thejoyor.com and you will be able to purchase a shirt. Oh, wait a minute. The connection went bad. What's wrong with the connection? Oh, there go. Miss Belita put it in there. There we go. It's right there, Dee Dee. TheJoyAmore.com. If you look, it's in the, you can just poke on it. No pork rinds, no butter beans, and no butter beans, honey. Did you get it, Dee Dee? So what we're going to talk about, y'all, I'm trying to stay on time, y'all. We got to learn how to keep this show. We can't go 4 hours tonight, y'all, because we got a lot going on this weekend and a lot coming up. So we got to try to keep the show short, okay? Thank you. This is my, go to the Nailist, thenailist.com. I'm wearing press-ons now. I miss my long nails, but these are okay. I do them myself. And yeah, they came this, I didn't have to do nothing but give myself a manicure and glue them on. Positive vibes. You can still go get your shirt. It's just going to be a little bit, we got a batch going out tomorrow. So that's why it says it's available until tomorrow, because we have a batch going out tomorrow. So if you want to get yours in that batch, because they make them in batches. So if you want to get them in that batch, you will order it now. If not, you can order it Friday. That's no problem. Thank you, Dee Dee. They last really good, Tiffany. Diva, don't quit. Never quit. Let me tell you something. They may, listen, one thing about it and two things for sure, they may get the best of the situation, but it ain't going to be because you gave up. You may take what I got from me, right? But I ain't going to give it to you. I won't give up. I promise you that. Never give up, girl. No matter what they tell you, no matter how much they try to tell you, you ain't nothing. Don't you ever give up. Never give up. Shanita, I go to the nail salon to get my feet done. I get pedicures, and that's only because of my big old brush. I can't get past my brush to do my feet. And I feel like the feet is far enough away from me because, you know, they have those shields. I'm going to go get a pedicure this week, and I'll take you guys along with me. I'll vlog it. But as far as nails, somebody working on my hands, I'm scared. So I've just been wearing press-on nails. No, don't they look good to be press-on? And they last forever. It's thenailist.com. I think I got a coupon code. Thank you, Arsh. Hey, Mama Lau. What's going on, Shakira? What's up, beautiful baby? What's up? What's going on, Mahogany? What's up, Kenya? What's going on, babe? Is my brother still on here, y'all? Y'all seen him? I ain't seen him in a minute. Yes, can we please get a like? Oh, Janice, I want to learn how to use polygel. never stop fighting until it's over, and then it still ain't over. What's up, Kathy? Right on it. Right. Exactly. Period. Right. Miss Belita, have you been getting my messages? I sent you some messages, Miss V, because I was worried about you, girl. Babe! Yo. Something in here frying. What's going on with my cabbage? It's burning?
Yeah, I'm doing good.
The beans? Yeah, put a little bit more. Please.
I did put some in there before I went outside.
Okay. Yeah, where is Biggs at, y'all? Yeah, Miss V, I sent you a message in a couple of different places. I messaged you on Patreon. I messaged you on Instagram. I was like, is she mad at me? Yes, you may lose the fight, but you'll never lose the battle. What's going on, Claire Bear? I like that name. Hello, Claire Bear. Thank you, Rose. Rose, you've been good at keeping my time, you and Arsh. Y'all keep me on time tonight. Listen, if you are in the... Why am I so loud, y'all? God, oh. If you're in my Patreon, y'all, can you please... we need to vote on what movie we're going to watch for movie night. I got a movie that I want us to watch, but I don't know if y'all going to want to watch it. So let's vote on what movie we're going to watch for movie night. I don't know, Shakira, we ain't got no subject. What you want to talk about, babe? What's on your mind? You know why, Miss 1960s girl? It's because my mother, I was a change of life baby. And my mother, the doctors told my mother that she would never have children. And when my mother was pregnant with me, they wanted her to terminate her pregnancy because at the same time as I was growing, there was a tumor growing with me. And they told her that she needed to take the tumor out, right? And my mama said, no, we're not going to take no tumor out. She said, when I go to have my baby, I'm going to have a cesarean section. And the tumor, y'all can take the tumor when I birth my baby. They was like, well, your baby going to be all right, but you're not going to make it if you don't let that tumor, you know, get that tumor get cut out. And my mama was like, well, I just won't make it, but y'all not going to cut on me. So... Once my mama went to have me, they went and the tumor was gone. It was no tumor, okay? So my mama had me when she was 40 years old. I was a change of life baby. Girl, I've been going through it since I was in the womb. I've been going through it. But I've been fighting since before I got here. So I think that because my mom had me so late in life, that's the reason why I'm so wise, because she spent so much time with me, you know? Hey, India, what's going on, lovely flower? Hello, Pamela. Thank you, boo. Y'all used to me being so loud. Y'all turn me down in the back. I'm sorry I'm so loud. It's true. That's my story. It's the truth. Love you, LaStacia. Hey, boo. What's going on? What's going on, Pamela? Y'all don't forget to hit the like button as you come in. Please like and share. I need somebody to share this on Twitter. Listen, y'all ain't new. Y'all my A1 day one. Y'all my queens. Y'all been here from the beginning. Y'all know what time it is. I'm not going to forget y'all either. I remember each and every one of you guys who send me messages, who encourage me, who buy my merch, who even tell me when I need to do better. I remember each and every one of y'all. No matter where we go, y'all going to be right there with me when I get there. What's up, Mahogany? What's up, babe? That's where I get my old soul from, is my mama. Because my mama did not chuck and jive with me. My mama kept it real and straightforward. She was very straightforward. I've been around older people my whole life. You got your sweater, Shakira? Yeah, listen, you guys, if you guys are ordering more merch, y'all got to send me pictures so I can feature you guys. I want to put your pictures in a video or put your pictures online. But if you don't send me pictures, I can't. So listen, if you're not already, head on over to Instagram. Make sure you're following me on Instagram. You guys are so engaging. I love the way you engage with me. Amber Rose, yes, I do want kids when the time is right. Absolutely. Yes, Missy, yes. Thank you, Deborah. I appreciate your support. You guys don't forget to hit the like button. That's okay, Shakira. You got an email. Right, Janice. Right. Amy, you haven't emailed me yet. I'm so glad you're on here. Amy, do you not want your free stuff? I'm like, why haven't Amy emailed me yet? Listen, Chloe, listen, girl. Will you know that someone got mad at me because they said I was ignoring them? Will you believe that? Someone got... Thank you, Robin. Hold on a minute. I just want y'all to read what Chloe has observed about me. Okay, Belita. Amy, please email me. But look at what Chloe has observed about me. Now, don't I take my time. Do you know that somebody was mad at me because they said I was not shouting them out or I wasn't talking to them? Whenever I went live, I was ignoring them. And I literally put on my glasses. Janice, I do it. I literally do it every single. Yeah, Stacy, come on over here to YouTube, girl. Thank you. Thank you. You guys share on Twitter. Tweet me, girl. Put me on. Share me on Twitter. Share me on Facebook. If you watch it on Facebook, girl, I need you over here on YouTube, girl. Okay, Miss Belita, I can't wait for that. I'm so excited. Studio, you know we're going to miss you, girl. I do. I shout out everyone, and I just could not believe that someone was mad at me because they said hello to me, and I didn't speak to them. Amy, girl. Bae, everything okay?
Yep.
What's burning?
Nothing. I had to suck a little water. We're out of stock, so we just had water in here.
It's okay?
Yep.
What about the cabbage?
Cabbage, come
on, good. Bae, what is you chewing and eating?
I'm being to make sure.
No, you in there eating. You don't need to make sure nothing is nothing.
Make sure we're not burning the beans.
Oh, Silk, I didn't know that. I do. I try to show as much love as I can. Deborah, girl, that's why I told her, I'm not trying to be mad, but I told her, I said, if you think that I, Joy, the Joy Amour, don't like you and ignore you, something is wrong with you, not me. Because I specifically take time out of my day to make sure I acknowledge everybody. And if I miss you, it's because I didn't see you. Yeah, Sharon, he in there eating. I think it's Miss Plus or More, girl. I think. Ooh, congratulations, guest lovely flower. Happy birthday to you. Happy, but tell that baby happy birthday. That I'm just like, I didn't understand that, Chloe. That's exactly how I feel, Kathy. No, but you know, that's a lesson that God is teaching me. I have to learn that we cannot worry about the opinions of men. We just can't. We cannot worry about people and what they think about you. Okay, Rose, thank you, boo. Y'all, we got 45 minutes left. We got to get it. What are we talking about? Vashti. What's going on, Vashti? That's okay, girl. What's up, Celine? I try to show as much love as I can because I love y'all. Y'all don't understand. Y'all have pulled me out of some of the darkest days. If it wasn't for you guys and my brother and, you know, Miss Belita and Chris and Tam and Janice and Studio and Chloe. You know what I'm saying? Arsh, Robin, y'all have pulled me out of some of my most darkest days. And so I want to make sure that I love you guys and I love on you as much as I can. I take every opportunity I can to love on you and engage with you guys. I don't care if I have 25,000 subscribers or if I go down and having 2 subscribers. It's going to be me and them 2 subscribers up here chilling and talking, period. Oh, I know, Kind Candy Girl, but I'm so tired, girl. I can't be, because I got a lot of work I'm working on, you guys. We got hair, listen, y'all, we got some more hair videos coming. We got laundry. Babe, what's burning? Turn it down, because something is sticking, burning and sticking. Okay, look, can I see the, can you take, the, what about the chicken? Can I see the beans? Can you bring the beans? Something burning.
A little water in there to keep them burning.
Oh, they look good. I don't know what's sticking.
It's the cabbage.
It's sticking?
It hadn't stuck yet, but it was, I took it off the burner.
But they're made done.
They're not done. That's why I put the water in there.
I don't like no crunchy beans.
I put the water in there. They were going to burn otherwise. Right,
y'all like crunchy green beans? I don't like no crunchy vegetables. Thank you, Basti. Ronnie, you like crunchy vegetables? I don't like no crunchy vegetables. I like my salt. That be hurting my teeth. And Chris, he love them crunchy vegetables like that. I cook my stuff to death. Okay, y'all, let's talk. We got about 50 minutes left. We're gonna get off at about, babe, can you bring me the house phone? Do you mind, or you want me to go get it? What's going on, Temple Red? I love seeing you on here, girl. What's up, bae? What's up, boo thing? How you doing with your pretty self? You want me to adopt you, Angelina? Girl, can I claim you on my taxes? Girl, I will adopt you as long as I can have you as a dependent, girl, because I need one. My God, today. Can I claim you on my taxes, girl? I need a dependent so bad. Oh, Lord, I need a dependent so bad. You hungry, Shonda? How you feeling? Shakira, girl, I'm serious. I'll be your mama. I'll adopt you as long as I can claim you on these taxes, girl. Ooh, Lord. I had to file mine late. I didn't file mine, I think, until this month. Did I file them this month or July? I think I filed. Babe, when I filed my taxes, July? Y'all had to file my taxes late. I owe $600. I was like, thank you, Jesus. $600. I can deal with $600. I'm doing good, honey. How are you? How was your day today? What are we talking about, y'all? Right, Ronnie. Listen, girl. I wish I could claim the cat as a dependent, girl. Then the cat can stay. Then it's my cat. If I can claim that cat as a dependent, it's my cat, period. What's up, studio? Yes. Oh, you know what, Divas? I rode by. They got early voting. Let me stop talking so loud. They got early voting in my city, and I rode by, and the whole parking lot was full. Full of. We was out there, we weren't playing. And I was so happy to see us out there, y'all. Y'all don't even understand. I was so happy. I don't like crunchy vegetables, Rose. The Braxtons, I like Mama Braxton. I don't know. The rest of them frustrate me. We chilling tonight, Chantel? Okay, bae. How do I feel about grocery delivery services? Hold on a minute. I missed somebody. Hold on 1 minute. Double standards in relationships. Ooh, that's a good subject. Wait a minute. Hold on. What do we think about the woman submitting in marriage? Ooh. What's going on, Peaches? Hey, boo. Positive vibes. I like grocery delivery services. I've had good experiences with them. What's going on, Biggs? Who gonna come on and talk to me tonight? Anybody coming on tonight? Hold on a minute. Who wanna come on and talk tonight? We got 40 minutes left in the show, y'all. We're gonna get off of here at 10 o'clock. No later than 10 o'clock. Wanda, you did. You did, Miss Wanda. Did y'all hear? Wait a minute. Ooh. Did y'all hear that that place in California had burnt down? They burnt, hello, Yvette. That they had burnt down that place where the people had put their ballots in there. Did y'all hear about that? Y'all, things is getting real crazy out here, y'all. Come on, y'all. Who gonna come and talk to me? Bestie, if you want to come on, I would love you to, but I know, you know, if you're not feeling it, don't worry about it. Whew. Y'all, the food's still cooking. Uh-uh, Shanita, we got time for that cat. Mm-hmm. Come on, Janice. Come on on. Let's talk, boo. Yeah, it was in California. They had a ballot box, right? And they say, now this is my question. If it was a ballot box and all the ballots in the box got burnt, how do y'all know who turned in their ballots in that box? They say that they're going to send people a new ballots. I heard about the Karen Law. Come on, whoever want to come on. They blowing them up. What's up, Shamika? What's going on, babe? Can y'all please do me a favor and hit the like button and make sure to share. Like and share, please. Like and share. Come on. Here go the link. If you want to come talk to me, come talk to me. We got about 40 minutes. 43 minutes. Let's talk. Y'all, we did good tonight. 8:40. We did over 2 hours, but what's the Karen Law? Yeah, let's talk about that. Yeah, I love Instacart. Me too, Rose. I like Instacart because they bring Publix. Miss Belita, when you get a chance, please check your inbox and Patreon. There go my baby. What's up, boo?
Hello.
How you doing, beautiful?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm so happy to see your face. How was your day today?
It was okay. It was okay.
What made it just okay? Girl, I can't see you. Can you turn on the lights like Teddy Pendergrass?
I'm going to try to cut a light on in here. Hold on 1 second.
Okay. No problem, studio. That's okay, Jessica. What's going on, Jessica Rodriguez? Me too, Tam. I feel like I'm over them. Yeah. I guess I should have put on a little, let me see. Which headband y'all like? Y'all like this one? This a headband wig. Y'all know this is supposed to be worn with a headband. Thank you, Rose. Please keep me up with the time. Please. Yes, welcome everyone. Thank you, Silk. I love you, moderators. Thank you guys for being on your job. Thank you guys for always showing up. I love you to all of my moderators. Thank you. I appreciate you. Y'all like this one? Thank you, Angelina. Chloe, we're going to watch. I think we're going to have a pajama party in Patreon. I've been talking to my babies about it for so long, and I know they're tired of me. They got tired of me, and they're ready to have it. So we're going to be having it before the end of this month. So probably not this weekend, but next Friday maybe. Y'all like it? Okay. There we go.
Sorry. Hi, I'm in.
Baby. What's up? What you want to talk about?
I brought up the double standards in relationships, but I don't know.
Yeah, let's talk about it. Let's talk about it. Yeah. Well, tell me what you mean.
You know how when women kind of step out of a relationship, it's like the end of the world. If especially even if a man has been messing around and you took him back and took him back. And if you do something, it's the end of the world. You gotta go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like that type of stuff.
But the reason is because that when a woman cheats, it's a different kind of cheat. First of all, there's a double standard. And thank you, Robin. There's a double standard. Okay. And when men cheat, supposedly, this is kind of like the... This is what people say. You know what I'm saying? This is according to society standards. When men cheat, people say that it's because it was just a physical thing. Hey, Sparkle. You know what I'm saying? It's just a physical thing. That there was nothing emotionally tied to it. That it wasn't emotional. It was just physical, right? And when women cheat, there's an emotional connection. That women are unable. I'm not saying this is not my opinion. This is what society standards say about cheating, men cheating versus women cheating, right? And right. Maybe this is just me playing devil's advocate and kind of giving the perspective on what people think. But you know, they say that when women cheat, number one, women are not impulsive. If a woman cheats on you. Or if you catch a woman cheating on you, 9 times out of 10, it's not the first time she's cheated. 9 times out of 10, she may be more involved in that relationship than a man, meaning that a man may just be seeking physical gratification. And a woman is, you know, she on her way leaving you, like you about to be out the door, bro.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's the kind of things that people say about women cheating versus men cheating. Now, is it acceptable either way? No.
Right.
But, you know, I don't know if you was raised like this, but even when I was raised, my mama used to always be like, Joy, you can't do what your brother do. My mama used to tell me that all the time. And I'm not going to put my brother business out there, but my mama used to always be like, Joy, you can't do what your brother do. You can, you know, you can, your brother can do this. Your brother can do that. You can't do that. I mean, like my brother could be dating someone or, you know, living with a woman. But if I was talking to a man on the phone past 12 o'clock, I was a streetwalker. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree. That's
pretty much. You know, my mama would always say, you can't do what a man can do. You have to be different, you know, because no matter, we can get called, you know, unsightly names just for having a conversation with a man.
Exactly.
So why do you think it's a double standard? Come on, y'all, tell what y'all think. Like, why is there a double, you know what I'm saying? What is the tea?
I totally agree with that, you know, that's the case most of the time when a female cheats, it's because they've been done with the relationship or they have been checked out and they just haven't left physically. But I just don't get the whole, well, I'm not gonna give you a second chance, you know, even though you may have given them several second chances and third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, eight, ten, nine.
That's whatever. True too. I'm not laughing at you, Janice. I'm laughing at my best friend who has zero sense.
Oh.
Babe, something's burning. Can you turn these stoves off? Hold on, y'all.
But that's true, Shonda. Like, I kind of feel the same way. Like, if you want to give it, then you're going to take it. And that's not, you know, that's just how it is, how it should be. But, you know, a lot of men will not take that kind of laying down the way that a lot of women do, and it's not cool. I mean, if you're cheating, you probably don't want to be in a relationship anyway, especially if you're a woman. But I mean, if you get caught and you want to stay, men don't give you that option a lot of times.
I'm coming back, girl. I'm sorry I had to check on this food. Krishna burnt the cabbage.
Huh?
I said, you don't burn the cabbage.
You burned that much.
But you did burn it.
No, I didn't. You off the stove. It wasn't quite done, but we, you know, we're trying to get done with limited resources.
Oh, because we ain't have no more
right.
Chicken stock.
Right.
I'm back, y'all. Okay, I'm sorry, babe. Go ahead. What happened?
Oh, nothing. I was just saying that men don't, you know, want to give you this the chance to keep the relationship going if they catch you cheating a lot of times. Not babe. Always.
No.
But come talk about cheating. Come talk about cheating. Yeah, come on.
I'm not cheating. What do you want to know about?
No. The question is, sit down.
Bring it back a little bit better.
Oh, where Janice went? Janice?
I have to exit out and come back, maybe.
Yes. Can you hear me, girl?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, hold on a second. I'm waiting on, I don't know what's going on, y'all. Hold on. What is going on?
I don't know why your phone is lagging behind, but that one.
Hey, Florida girl, what's going on, babe? What's going on, Donna? Can you hear me? Talk to me.
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay, there we go. Okay, so what now? Okay, there go, babe.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey.
Do you think that it's worse when a woman cheats or when a man cheats?
That's a low. Sure.
Which one is worse?
I think they're both equally bad. What's wrong with the stream yard?
I don't know what's wrong with it.
You're a kid,
I can hear you, but I can't see you. But do I need to back out and come back in? Maybe.
Okay, hold on. Let me see. Hold on. I don't know what's going on. Can y'all hear me? We had to switch cameras. I don't know what's going on with the sound. I don't know what happened, but I apologize about the quality right now, but hopefully y'all can still hear me. No, she coming back.
Oh, okay.
Y'all can hear me? Okay. I think cheating is bad, period. But I do think that sometimes it's, I don't know, I think women are better at cheating than men. What's going on, Florida girl, with your pretty self? You so pretty. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Which one, men or women, is better?
Women. Men are dumb.
Okay.
Because the moment that you cheating on me, I can smell you and know when you ain't. You went somewhere you didn't tell me that you were supposed to go.
You got a good sense of smell.
No, I can. You can tell me. He can tell me that he went somewhere, and I'm gonna be like, "No, you smell like the gas station. You smell. You don't smell. You smell different." Yo, smell. I can smell him when he don't be somewhere that, like, that's different. I'm like, why you smell? Your smell is different.
Listen, the smell, the environment, everything.
I can't hear her.
The volume on this one.
No, it's not the volume. I just can't hear her.
Well, no, you got
this.
Hello.
Oh, I do. Okay, hold on 1 minute.
You hear this one? Because you got that one right.
Oh, can you hear me now? There we go. Okay. I'm sorry, girl. We got technical difficulties. Y'all know, listen, this is a privately traded company, girl. So we ain't there yet. I'm sorry for the camera quality. For whatever reason, that one went out.
That's okay.
No, but I can smell when he's been somewhere that ain't right, and he'd be like, well, how do you know? I said, because you don't smell right. I can smell it on you.
Yeah.
And you dumb. You acting different. Let me tell you something, ladies. If you ever think that a man is cheating on you, a clear sign that a man is cheating on you is when they start bossing up. When they start picking fights and arguing with you about stuff and fussing and fighting with you, they cheating. They running around. They talking to somebody else. When a man starting arguments with you,
yeah,
they arguing and fighting with you, and no matter what you do, there's something wrong. He cheating. Leave him. Don't even ask. Just leave. Because he cheating. Because nothing you can do, because in their mind, you're not that other woman. So nothing you do going to be right. Put his ass out. Chris, no, I'll put you out in a minute.
Put the clothes out.
I will put you and your shit out the door. In 2 minutes.
And the cat.
I used to be real bad about that. I used to kick Chris out once a week.
And the kid.
Every week I'd be kicking him out. Stuff on dinner.
Yeah. But no.
You did do something. You did a whole lot. I'm serious, Florida. When somebody start, okay, when somebody, listen, let me tell you something.
when somebody start hopping and skipping and laughing to themselves and and they just skipping around and just watch them. I'm just sitting there looking at you like,
what do you have going on?
What you laughing and keep? What's funny? I want to laugh. What's so funny?
Exactly.
What you laughing at? They cheating.
Yep.
They running around. And let me tell you something. You have to be, and I don't know, like, maybe I'm a bad person at this, but I just feel like at this point in life, your body, when you cheat with your physical body, to me, it's like, that's putting your life at risk.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't know where, men don't think about stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? They don't think about how clean somebody is or, you know what I'm saying? They don't know they can go and get a disease from them and bring you back HPV. And next thing you know, you got cancer because he cheating.
But not only that, Joy, but if you going outside of the relationship, you add in a third person who could be jealous and crazy and try to do something to you based on them having feelings for the other person. You know what I mean?
It's not necessary because my whole thing is you don't got to cheat on me. Please tell me, please. Please. Because I don't know whatever we doing, I just want to know. Let me know what it is we doing so I can know what to do. That's another thing. A person will start accusing you. They'll start, where are you going? Where are you being? Why are you taking so long? Because they trying to make sure y'all don't meet each other while y'all both out there doing what you're doing.
Yeah.
But men, see, when a man start putting on new drawers, he been wearing the same dusty-ass pair of drawers for the last 12 weeks, and all of a sudden he going to come home and get a brand new pack of Fruit of Looms. Girl, he cheating, girl. The hell he need new drawers for? Now, all before now, he been wearing them raggedy-ass hole-in-the-front boxer shorts. Now he going to go get some JCPenney silk shorts. Yo, ragged ass don't even know how to buy no silk drawers. You cheating. Thank you, Rose. Because a woman done told you look good in silk drawers. You too sweaty for silk drawers. You old sweaty, rusty, crusty self.
Yep. And women, I know not only when you was talking about the smell, it's the smell, the environment, everything. Like, I could pay attention to, I remember I came home one day and it was like a piece of gum out of place. And I told my husband, I said, where did that gum come from? And he was like, what are you talking about? And I was like, that gum was not here when I left.
Who had gum?
Right. And it was like one piece of chewing gum. But I know my house, I know my car, I know everything. So no matter where you go or if somebody come over here, it's innocent or not, I'm gonna know what's going on.
Thank you, Brenda. What's going on, Brenda? Yes, Diva. That's a big one. Cologne. When they start smelling different, I'm telling you, I don't know what movie that was in. She was like, let me smell yo. Remember, let me smell it. Because you can smell it. I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And by the time you're getting into all of that extra, you know, detective stuff, you know what's going on.
You know, you have a feeling of it, and it's sad, but you know, people cheat for different reasons. But I mean, listen, we got a whole COVID-19 out here right now. We ain't got time for, listen. Mm-hmm. And you know, listen. Mm-mm.
I totally agree. It's too much, and I would much rather
too much.
Than for somebody to do something behind my back. But you know, if you are going to do that, then like you said, you need to let someone know that it's over.
Let me know so that I can have the chance and the opportunity to walk up out of there and get my business and be out. Like, you know what I'm saying?
People don't want to leave a comfortable situation. You know, they have somebody that's taking care of them either financially or, you know, being supportive of their business or however.
And this is the thing, my whole thing is, and I tell Chris all the time, listen, if you don't want me, please let me go. Please, I beg you, please. Please let me out. I'm looking up. Please, Claire Bear. Well, you know what, Claire Bear? Maybe next time. I can't today because it's 9:40. So we technically have been on for 2 hours, but I'm going to let it go until 10 o'clock. Shakira, you know what? Oh, she said side chicks. Listen, sugar babies and side chicks are definitely having a hard time. Rona cheating. I mean, it's just not safe. But maybe with Claire Bear, hopefully you'll subscribe to my channel and you'll come back. I'm so happy to see your name. Hey, Marcia. What's going on, Marcia? Where you been? I didn't know you was on here, girl. What's going on, Donna? Claire Bear, I want you to come back, and we're going to talk about that on the next show. We're going to talk about, can you recover from cheating? Because this is my belief. I don't think that anybody else should tell anybody else what to do. If their relationship recover for cheating, because, you know, look, people love to be like, I would never stay with somebody who cheated on me. Because right. If they cheated on me, I'm out. Well, that's you.
Right.
You can dictate what somebody else can do or what, you know, a relationship can survive or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, so maybe we'll talk about that on the next show.
That's a good topic. That's a good topic. I didn't think about discussing, you know, further into that, but that's a good topic because you can recover from it. If both people,
you can recover from anything you wanted to recover from. Celine, no, Celine, no. No, girl.
She said she was taking everything.
Thank you, Mel, for watching.
But you know, that's how you do it, Celine.
Right. Now that's my question. Thank you, Rose. I love Rose. Thank you, Boo, my timekeeper. That's true, though. Y'all, please excuse this camera quality. I had to switch cameras because we was having technical difficulties.
They are dogs because they will attach right. The first thing moving. That's why.
Not broke, broke. Yes, Claire, please be on the next live so that way we can talk about it. And please making sure, please make sure that you guys remind me. Don't let me forget. On our next show, we're going to talk about, can you recover from cheating? How do you recover from cheating? And also, how do you feel? Like, for me, this is another thing I want to talk about. Is there a difference from cheating to where, like, what if no one knows about it? And then when everybody knows about it, you know what I'm saying? Like, one of those situations where you're the last person to know that someone's cheating on you, and everybody around you, even your family, like, you know, people like that will know that someone's cheating on you and then not let you know. So is it worse when, you know what I'm saying? You're basically being embarrassed. Because my thing is, don't embarrass me. Because, see, y'all know I'm ignorant. So you can't embarrass me. Like, wherever you want to have it, we can do it. Anywhere you want to do it, however you want to do it. I'm not going to be embarrassed. Because both y'all going to be sitting up here looking at each other like fools. Because I'm out.
It's probably easier to recover from that if it's not public and if people haven't found out. Because then it's just you and him trying to figure this out, not you, him, his mama, your sister.
And then that's another thing I'm so glad you brought that up, Janice, because you know what happens? We go and tell our family members what a man has done to us. And then we forgive the man, but our family don't forgive them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't do that. If me and my, even before we got married, like anything that happened between us, was between us, you know what I'm saying? Because I knew that as long as I'm in the relationship for real and we're trying to work it out, there's no need for me to go telling my friend, my sister, everybody what he done did to me, because then they're going to hate him and I'm going to be in love 2 days from now and it's going to be, they're going to be looking at him with daggers in their eyes for the rest of their life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's true, Divas. You can't have everybody in your business because everybody ain't for you. Yeah, but did she truly recover? Do we know that she recovered? I mean, like, did she really recover? I don't know. I guess. Oh, that is so wonderful, Deborah. Congratulations, my beautiful queen. I'm so happy for you. I think it depends also on what, I don't know. I think it just depends, like, because, like, okay, stuff that I would have put up with when I was younger, like when I was in my 20s and like 22s and stuff like that, mentally now, especially since my mama has died, like, since my mama has died, my tolerance level and my patience for, like, crazy stuff, I just don't have no patience. Like, I don't have no patience for stuff, you know, stuff that I probably would have been like, okay, we can get through this. We can bounce back from this, blah, blah, blah. Girl.
Because you don't have time. You don't have time for that foolishness. Like, you don't have
I can't. Not no more. I just can't. I mean, it's not that I don't want to. I love you. Like, I never thought that I could love someone and not be with them. But now, at this point in my life, I can love you and I don't have to be with you. I can love you from a distance.
Yeah. Because you don't have time for that foolishness. Like, I don't, I feel the same way. I'm too old. We done been through too much. I don't
it's
have
too much.
I'm not interested in trying to talk about this for 7 years and fix this and No.
Yeah. Okay, sorry. I keep smelling something. Thank you, Arsh. That's it, Devil. That's it, Cotton Candy. Whatever's done in the dark will always come to the light. Yes. Oh, Tam, that's true now. That is true. Soul ties.
That's true.
Soul ties. That's soul ties. Thank y'all for keeping me abreast of the time. Because like I said, I got to get off here at, I'm going to try, let's say 10:15. 10 o'clock, 10:15. Because we're going to eat a little bit. Because it's late, but we're going to eat a little bit. Good night, Mahogany. Thank you so much for being here, my love. What else do we got to talk about, Janice?
I don't know. That's,
you always have some good stuff, this girl. You had to work today?
No, I was off today. I'm having a procedure done in the morning. That's why I can't eat.
Oh, you having a procedure? Well, we'll talk about it.
Yeah. Yeah.
On top of it.
But I've been off for a couple days because of that. And so I'm just relaxing right now.
Okay, boo. If there's anything that I ask you or that I say that makes you feel uncomfortable, please tell me, like, you know, because I don't mean no harm.
No, it's no problem. I'm pretty much an open book.
Thank you, Miss Sheila, for the $5. Is Sheila still here? I just now got the $5, babe. Thank you. Okay, hold on. Let me, Bestie say she want to come on. Hold on a minute.
Okay, good.
No, you stay right there. I'm finna, I got to get on Facebook. When y'all see me squinting, tell me to put my glasses on. Because I be sitting here squinting like a fool. Hold on a minute. Let me get Bestie. Where's she at? There she go. You coming on, Bestie? You feel like it? Huh?
Yeah, I took my medicine.
I'm good. Okay, we're going to be on for about 15 more minutes. You want to come on and talk?
That's just fine.
Okay, come on. I sent you the link on Facebook.
Okay.
Okay, Bestie. Bye.
Yeah, because I don't have another topic, so maybe she can pick it up.
No, you good, girl. You fine. You just chill. We just chilling. We at the house. Y'all are at my house. We just doing a kickback. I know it's like 300 people, but y'all, listen, I don't know where y'all parked at, but y'all all at the house, and we just chilling. Dennis, you got to help me remind me to post in Patreon what movies we going to watch.
Okay.
Everybody wishing you good luck, Janice. Y'all pray. We gonna pray.
Thank you.
Bye, Diva. I love you, Queen. Thank you for being here. Now, Lala, what's going on, babe? I ain't seen you. Where you been? Studio, where was your topic at? Did I miss it? You said emotional cheating versus physical cheating, right? There go my Bestie. Hey, boo!
Hello.
Hey, boo!
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, boo.
I like that.
What's up, boo? Bonnet?
Yeah, it's the bonnet.
What you want to talk about, Bestie?
No, Studio said she had a subject, but I didn't see it.
Y'all want to see this plate that Peyton brought me?
This what?
Y'all want to see my plate?
Let's see it. Because I'm hungry. Let's get it. Oh,
that's dirty.
I'm so hungry.
That's dirty.
Y'all look at these green beans. Look at this chicken, green beans, cabbage, y'all.
That's dirty.
I ain't ate since them pickles and cheese I was telling you about earlier.
That's the last thing you ate, Tria?
Yeah. Yeah.
Heavenly Father, we come to you. We thank you right now for this food that we're about to receive. Lord, bless the hands that prepared it. Lord, thank you so much for the fellowship with my subscribers. Lord, I just pray that you touch everybody. Lord, thank you so much for this opportunity. And thank you for the all that you've done and that you're about to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Lord, please don't let me have no calories from this food, Lord. Rebuke the calories in Jesus' name.
Okay.
Rebuke the calories.
That's a prayer. That's a prayer.
Lord.
So, okay, so. Shakira, you gonna report me? My God, today.
For real.
Don't report me. Thank you, y'all. You part okay? I'm gonna bring your listen, Lola. I'm gonna bring you a play outside, girl. Shonda just had surgery. That's why she, you know, she tired. She had surgery. She came on here with me.
Oh no, cause I just like being on here with y'all. Be having a good time.
We do.
Huh?
Yeah, Shakira.
What?
Okay, y'all. Okay, so listen, friend. Studio say she want to talk about emotional cheating versus
physical. I think I would take emotional cheating way more personal, especially coming from a man. But both would make me upset because emotional means that evidently you don't want me and you've attached yourself to somebody else for some reason or a part of yourself. And then the physical is, you know, just the sharing of the body. But to me, that physical come with a little bit of emotions too.
Right.
So, I mean, in emotional, I guess the just emotional without the physical, the one is just as bad as the other. Because what was for me supposed to be for me. So if you sharing, you know, we got a problem.
Love you, Chantel. Right. You got a problem either way, bestie.
Yeah. I mean, either way, it's bad. And then one over the other don't make me feel no better. Look at her praising God for the food. Look at her. She's terrible.
You know, I was thinking that the man, worst men or women, I was thinking about the cheating and dependency. What I mean by that?
Women, what'd you say cheating independent?
Cheating and dependency. Okay. For example, let's say that the...
We can't hardly hear you.
Yeah, I know. It's hard because I'm on the wrong side of the computer. Yeah, cheating and dependency. Let's say that the woman is dependent upon that guy for a place to live, a car to drive, you know, helping taking care of the kid. You know, let's just say it's because that's how, historically how it's been. The man's been the breadwinner, and let's say that the man is the guy that goes out and cheats, but she's too afraid to tell it to bring it up or to push him out because she don't have anywhere else to go. Follow what I'm saying? It could be the opposite. Maybe the man's not, you know, maybe the woman's the breadwinner and he's kind of just hanging around and she might go out and get something going on, but he can't afford to bring it up because he ain't got nowhere else to go.
Yeah, but that's why you don't let people put you in that position. You always keep yourself to where somebody can do you like that.
Right.
Exactly. And if you find yourself in that position, just stay quiet. And get your little stuff together quietly. And then when you finish what you got to do, surprise they ass.
Mm-hmm.
And go on about your business. And let them keep thinking they doing whatever they're going to do. Don't show out. Don't get upset. Don't even let them know you know. Just quietly get your stuff together. Get your little ducks in a row and go on about your business.
Right. Exactly.
I mean, sometimes we find ourselves in a space where we can't, you know, just jump up and do something. And that's okay. But
hey, Asia, what's going on, Mariah?
You try not to do that. I tell my kids that my mama told me the same thing. Don't ever get so dependent where somebody can treat you any kind of way.
On anybody.
Never do that.
Exactly.
My mom told me the same thing.
Because people will do that to you with anything, with your money, with your time. When you let people, you know, feel like you in a space where you have to have them or they're necessary for you to exist.
Mm-mm. Then they
you know how they say, don't let your right hand know what your left hand is doing. Is that what they say?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I know my right lip. Girl, this chicken, girl. Y'all, look at this chicken. Can I show y'all this chicken?
No.
Girl, look,
no.
Look at the spices and the herbs, girl.
No.
You know what? And then you can't eat. I was in the same position a couple days ago where I couldn't eat.
No.
And I was just sitting around talking about drink 12 ounces of Gatorade. I don't want no dang on Gatorade.
Oh, wait. Janice, you can't eat?
That's what I said. I said, this is torture.
Janice, Janice, I'm so sorry. It's horrible of me.
You so busy eating your meal alone.
12 to 12.
Don't be telling my business. No, they don't need to know that. Don't be telling my business. Don't do that. Shh.
No.
Babe, no. No. They don't need to know, but I don't know who's on here. Your ragged ass ex-wife be watching him. I don't need her to know my game plan with her raggedy, bald headed. Anyway, excuse me. I'm gonna show y'all in Patreon the message that I got.
Well, I will be looking for that.
Okay.
What time is it tomorrow that you got to go, Janice?
8 a.m.
Okay.
I have some chicken broth.
You have some what, babe?
I said I have some chicken broth.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry.
We have clear fluids.
That's okay. I'm going to make up for it tomorrow, believe me.
I'm trying to tell you. First thing I did when I woke up was looking for the groceries. Hello. Can I get it? Please and thank you. Give me food.
I'm so sorry, Janice. I didn't know you had to be NPO, babe. I'm just sitting up here smacking.
But you're not as bad as my husband, because he said, well, can you fix my plate? I said, what?
Studio got her bonnet on, too.
Yes, bonnet.
Yeah,
I'm going to take my wig off and go get my bonnet.
Yeah, somebody said I look sleepy. That's because I'm high. I'm on. Do you want to see all of my?
All your bed.
Hydros.
She says she's high. Listen,
prescribed medication. She had to take prescribed medication because she had surgery.
Yeah.
I just want to say, Bestie, I'm so proud of you.
So. I'm only halfway.
I'm so proud of you, Bestie. You was a trooper, and I'm so proud of you that you got your surgery, and now you're going to be going to physical therapy, and you're going to be straight, and we're going to twirl. Twirl? Mm-hmm. You going on vacation?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
I don't know how we're going to do it with the COVID. Man, you almost burnt my cabbage. You thought I wasn't going to notice.
Yeah, I just gotta get through. I'm saying this is the first day home, so you know. Yeah. I'll stay high. Every 4 hours I get high.
You'll be okay.
Bestie, no. In the name of Jesus, Miss Valita, pray for you.
Amen.
Thank you, because I can't see the comments. Thank you for putting it up.
Yeah, everybody's saying nice things. They praying for you. Angela say, hey, Angela. Everybody praying for you.
Thank you.
What you mean, studio? Figure out what? A girl's trip? Yeah, we need to, y'all. We doing a cruise, studio. Dutch means that everybody pay for their own food. That's the devil's work.
Amen, because I am not Dutch, period.
I ain't going Dutch. I'm not Dutch at the house. And my drawers and a t-shirt. If I put a wig on for you, you paying for this date. Now, I go Dutch, but I ain't going to wear no wig or no bra or no drawers or no girdle or no heels or no nails. I would take all the money that I would have further invested in my maintenance and pay for my date.
Yeah,
I just stay home.
Yeah, well, I think that only because I don't choose the man, he chooses me. So if you chose me to go out with you, then the expectation is that, you know, you're choosing what's within your price range and I'm showing up because you asked me to. So there shouldn't be any expectation of me other than to show up. Now, if I ask you on a date, then I guess it would be expected that I pay, but I don't ask men out on dates because I'm not that one.
Right.
I do that. So if you ask me, then, you know, you need to shop within your budget.
That's totally correct.
Because I've been asked out, and I've been asked out on cheap dates and expensive dates, and I've been asked to McDonald's, and I declined because I don't want him to think that that's how I get down. But, you know, it is what it is. But then let him know, that's just not. What about a first date, though?
Listen, ladies, this is what I need you to do. When you're first meeting someone, you got to look at all of the information. You need metrics. You need data. Because it's not about the money. You can pay for everything yourself. Thank you, Rose. Y'all, we got about 10 more minutes. It's not about the money. It's the way that a man thinks. You don't want to be with somebody who think that you should be paying for dates.
Exactly.
Even if you want to pay for the date, that's fine. But you should, if you go to pay for a date and a man buys Chantel and a man says to you, what are you doing? Why, you know, no, like, you want to be with somebody that's going to be offended by you paying for a date.
Yeah,
that might be the kind of man, but that's not the only thing you want to look at,
right?
Just one thing, you got to look at all of it as a package,
right? For me, also, you had no business.
You was driving a what's that Toyota?
Yeah.
No, what's the hybrid one?
A man has no business. If I was single, I am 38 years old. Educated, got all my own shit. So if you want to talk to me and you cannot afford to take me on a date, I have to have a certain standard. Right. So my expectations.
Go ahead, Bessie, and then I'll say what I got to say.
My expectation is that you can at least do that. And I just, to me, you have no business talking to me if you can't at least do that. I'm too old and I know what I want, and that ain't it.
I think it's different for everybody. And listen, I'm not telling anybody what to do. Mm-hmm. I'm saying, what'd you say, Bestie?
I said, you do whatever's comfortable for you. I'm talking about for me. Right. For me personally,
I'm talking about me. Now, me or more, I agree with you because to me, I've already set the expectation before you brought your ass over here. So whether you pay or not, we're clear. I don't leave any, did I? Mm-hmm. When he came over here and was like, let's go on a date, I said, first of all, we going on a date at 8:00 in the morning. Just so you already know what time it is, we're going on a breakfast date because I'm not going to waste my whole day waiting to see your ass and then to be on some BS. Our date is going to be at 8:30, 9:00 in the morning. We're going to breakfast. Breakfast is very inexpensive. If you can't afford breakfast, we don't need to be talking.
If I can afford IHOP.
Come on, IHOP. You can't do IHOP. Come on, really?
Orange
juice, some pancakes and bacon for at least $25. Come on. I mean, bruh. It's breakfast. And I need my whole day. You're not going to take up my whole day. Because I need to know, and I'm going to know 30 minutes in, whether I'm ready to go.
Yeah.
So before we order food, I'm like, hey, let's just order some orange juice or some apple juice. Let's have coffee. Let's talk. If I stay long enough to order food, it's because I'm interested. Because if I'm not interested, I'm going to be like, you know what?
You're not even going to go in.
Listen, I will see your ass from the car and be like...
Well, but the thing is, as far as that expectation stuff, I feel like when you met me and we talked, because of my, we go instantly go on a date, you got to know me and you know what kind of lady I am. And to me, you know that there is no expectation at the end of the night. So, I mean, it doesn't matter what time it is, because you know that that's not what's happening. So sometimes I guess guys can get that confused, but
ain't no confusing. I don't owe you anything,
you especially
ain't getting no ass today.
Especially not over no meal.
Exactly, not over whatever much you spent on the meal, whether it was IHOP or a 5-star restaurant.
Yeah. Unless we have discussed some type of deal.
And if it was just going to be that, then I wouldn't even wasted my time with you at breakfast.
Or unless I came with my paperwork so you can put something on a bill. There is no expectation. If you are childish enough, grown man, to expect sex because you bought somebody some food, you ain't for me anyway.
No.
If that's what you for real think, then you, that ain't, no.
That's a whole nother type of person.
Right.
And that's fine, but it's not over here.
Right. Exactly. Look at her. I'm sick of her.
This is plate. This bay plate.
Oh, okay.
I'm the fat one, but it's my plate.
I'm still waiting on my chicken wings.
I'm gonna make you some chicken wings. This bestie, when you come and we go on vacation, we're not going. I don't know. I said we was gonna get a resort. But I want us to go like where we can get a condo. You seen Chelsea video that went to Miami?
No.
For Dion's birthday.
I saw her packing, but I didn't watch it. They had an Airbnb?
Huh?
They had an Airbnb. Yeah, I like Airbnb.
You know, she liked to get some Airbnbs and get 3 or 4 people in it, and then it'd be cheap.
Yeah,
They can go to Walmart and then you can get you know, we can get food and I can cook. I would. Yeah. And then we can save money.
I love Airbnbs. All the ones I've ever had were really nice.
Yeah. Maybe we can find one close to the resort.
Yeah. It's fine with me. I'm down for whatever.
Okay.
Long as I'm out of here and free.
We're going to get our COVID test and make sure we got COVID.
COVID test so many times now. I'm like your president.
Good night, Deborah.
Good night.
Where are we going back to? Where I said we was going?
You said Marco. Is it Marco Island?
Marco Island.
But
I want to go to Miami too, but we going to Marco Island.
Yeah,
you know what? Positive vibes. I do bake, but I'm going to start for the holidays starting next month. I'm going to get better with my baking because I want to really do some healthy baking, like with almond flour and like keto breads. And I really want to get adventurous. Mia Moore, I agree with you. Claire, you like Marco Island?
Yeah, I never been. I didn't even know nothing about Marco Island until Joy mentioned it to me, and I went on ahead and Googled. I had never heard of it.
Is that near? Is that, where is that?
In Florida, it's somewhere.
In Florida.
Okay.
Okay, Claire Bear Ben.
Claire Bear, yes, Claire. Claire, where did you stay when you went? Yo, I'm spitting. I'm talking with my mouth full.
I have to see where that is because I'm in Florida too, but I don't know how.
Oh, close. I didn't know, Janice. Where you at?
Pensacola.
Oh, I'm sick of y'all.
I love Pensacola.
I want to be in Florida.
Are you sure? Because it's
hot. Look where she stayed at, Bestie. Bestie, look at where Claire stayed at.
Where?
The JW Marriott.
Oh, I love it. I love the Marriott. That's one of my favorites. They got a bomb breakfast buffet. Oh my God. I love a good breakfast at a hotel.
Nancy, you ain't gonna be getting up in time enough to go to breakfast.
No. I get up and put on pretty pajamas, eat the buffet, and go back to bed. I don't miss no buffet. And I go back to bed.
That sounds like a plan.
Yeah, and then after you eat that good food, that's the best sleep ever.
Oh my goodness. That's what Bessie be hating on me, because I want to stay in the hotel. I don't want to be out and about. I just want to stay at the hotel or at the Airbnb and watch TV. Ooh, Aruba, yes. That's, see, y'all, yeah. These my kind of women. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I love Fort Lauderdale. Yes, come through Fort Lauderdale. Come through Broward.
Mm-hmm. I'm going somewhere January 31st. I don't remember.
Bessie, well, you going on a cruise.
I know, but where are we going?
I don't remember.
I don't remember.
That's bad.
I just want to go. I don't care where it's going to. I can't recall. Is it Puerto Rico, maybe, or Dominican? I don't know. Somewhere out of here. We going to New Orleans, and then we going to get on the boat, and I'm going wherever they take me to.
All the cruises from around here have been canceled.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I know, no more buffets with the Rona. I know. But I wonder if the breakfast buffet at the... Well, no, we went to a hotel. We had a vacation, and they were serving us. They had the buffet blocked off with them plastic things, and they, you stick your plate up under there, and the people serve you on your plate.
That makes sense.
Yeah. So, you that know, so that, not, yeah. so that we not touching
That's
stuff.
That's how buffets should be anyway. If these nasty people don't know how to eat. I can't stand
Mm-hmm. Ooh, these wiping their eyes and stuff, and then touching stuff other people got to touch.
I agree.
I'm going to Turks and Caicos. Who said that? Who knows where I'm going? Who is that? Mariah. See, she know. How she know?
Bessie, you forgot.
I had a brain lapse. You know I'm medicated. Medicated. I gotta keep the bonnet on, keep my brain cells together.
Oh my God.
To keep my brains together. But I would have went wherever, I don't care. Wherever they let me go, wherever they take me to. And especially when I could stand up and walk without pain. I'm going.
That is a blessing.
I can't wait.
Mm. Oh, really, Claire? Mm. Y'all, that food was so good, y'all.
It looked good.
Oh, my God. You ever cook and forget that you can cook that good and scare yourself? I'm like, no, I forgot.
I did that one time with some greens, and then I cooked it with some smoked turkey tails in it, and then I put it on my plate with some cut up fresh tomatoes and fresh onion and a little bit of hot sauce, and oh my God, I was like, oh my God. Oh, just a plate of greens.
That sounds so good.
And then that little smoked turkey meat on them turkey tails. Whew.
Hopefully as soon as Bestie gets in her recovery.
When I'm not handy capables no more.
So hopefully before the end of the year. I'm scared too, Celine. I'm so scared, but I'm hoping I can go, and I hope my brother comes, and I hope we have a good time.
I'm not scared because I'm going to mind my business, but I'm not going to go somewhere and can't do nothing. Ain't no point in going, like how people going to Vegas right now and stuff. I don't see the point in that.
No, ain't no point in that.
But, you know, when they give us free, I'm going to be ready. Well, I love the Marriott as well.
like the Marriott World Center. Y'all ever been to Marriott World Center? Oh my God, it's in Orlando. You babe, we got a problem. Babe,
is that
there's a problem?
Huge hotel.
Hmm.
Babe, why you do stuff to aggravate me? You really love to aggravate me. Yes, you do. That's why you laughing.
I believe it, Chris Coco. But that's why they doing the people can't touch the buffet no more. So you ain't got to worry about the germs because the folks ain't touching it.
Yeah.
Because I'll be watching people wipe right across their face and nose and then go up there and grab a spoon.
And then, or if they put something on their plate, then they'll take their hand and put it back. You know what I'm saying? I'd be like, oh, no, I can't do it. I was in line trying to get a plate. I'll never forget. Chris was so mad at me. But this lady was in front of me, and she took the scoop and put it on her plate, and some of it fell off. And she took it and flung it back into the whole thing. I said, I dropped my plate and walked off.
Now that's dusty. She will try.
I would have left.
I dropped my. I said no. I said you don't do that. I was like, oh my God,
it's time to go.
Yeah, and Chris was just like so embarrassed. And I was like, oh my God, no, you don't do that.
No, because other people have to eat that.
I was like, why would you do that? That is so disgusting. I said, this whole thing is contaminated. And she was like, I was like, I'm like, that's nasty. I was just like, I can't. So after I seen that, but I don't like buffets. Like, buffets really scare me. Oh my God, it's very hard for me to do buffets. Like, so I like it that they're going to be serving it because that's how it should be anyway.
Yeah. Even on a cruise, you can't touch the food no more. They're going to put it on there for you.
Florida, when is your birthday? My birthday's in December too. I got to ask Biggs, where did he stay when he was in Jamaica? Okay, y'all, listen. I love y'all. I done stayed with y'all 21 minutes after I said I was going to go. I got to go. I can't stay. I'm finna call you on the phone, bestie.
Okay.
So don't go to bed yet.
I can't go to bed.
Okay.
I gotta eat. And
hey, Blue Bunny. Listen, you guys, do me a favor, please, and don't forget to say a prayer for my friend. Say a prayer for Janice for her procedure to go well tomorrow. I just pray that you have blessed, that you're blessed. And Janice, please, when you get through, can you message me on Patreon? If you can, you know, good. If not, I understand.
Yeah.
Wait, let what?
Let us know you good.
I will. Thank you. To take the spoon and licked it with his mouth. So I took my
no, he did not. No, he did not. No, he did not. Wow. No.
Oh my God. Oh, that's horrific. Okay, so listen, you guys, don't forget. Head on over there to the Patreon, www.patreon.com/joyandmore. Y'all going over there. We have a good time. We're gonna have that we're gonna have our December 4th. My birthday is December 2nd. We 2 days apart, Florida girl. I'm on the 2nd. Mm-hmm. And listen, don't play me. I need birthday and Christmas separate. I don't want one gift. Period.
Bro. I hate December people always trying to act like you get two gifts.
I do get gifts. What are you talking about? Really?
December babies get two gifts, and then I'm in February, so I need something for Valentine's and my birthday. So
right, period.
It's rolled into the other.
No.
No.
It's hey, rolled.
Night, Shakira, listen, all my beautiful babies, I love you so much. Don't forget to go on there and join the Patreon. Also, don't forget, go get your merch, girl. We got y'all seen that Queen show. Y'all know it was cute. You know it was everything, period.
I can't wait to wear mine.
You got it?
Yeah, I got it before my surgery, the day before, I think.
Oh, that's why I remember.
Mm-hmm.
Because you was excited.
Mm-hmm.
But listen, y'all, we got a lot of good stuff. Y'all, listen, y'all, they done put me in lingerie, y'all. I've got lingerie, y'all. Please, I need all the support I can get.
I love that clip of you in that lingerie. I was like, look at this. This is, like, you were beautiful.
Thank you so much, y'all. I'm so scared and so nervous. I feel like my mama gonna come out the grave and whoop my behind, even though I'm 33 years old. I'm like, oh my God. I'm a grown woman and I'm still scared. But listen, I love you, Janice. Please reach out to me tomorrow. Bestie, I'm finna call you, girl, because you look like you is toe down. You, your eyes is hanging low. Bestie, you is toe down, bestie.
She looks like she just, her eyes.
She is just floating on a cloud. Bestie, yeah. Oh my God.
It's the meds.
That's how she looks.
It's the meds.
Bestie, I love you. I'm going to call you, okay?
Okay.
That's funny. Good night.
Bye, my love. I'll talk to you soon. Thank you for coming on and talking to me. I love you, my loves. Listen, you guys, don't forget, go on over there and get your merch. Y'all use code FALL, FALL, so y'all can save y'all some coin. Girl, y'all go on over there to Dax Spices, D-A-K-S. Y'all, they were a huge part of my weight loss success thus far because I needed to have that flavor in my food, okay? So y'all go on over there to Dax, D-A-K-S, spices.com, and y'all get y'all, at least if you can get two seasonings, get the Italian seasoning and get you some of the original red. Just go and get you them two and start with it and then go from there, okay? Listen, I love you guys so much. Rose, will you please make sure you be here? Matter of fact, let me, hold on, Rose. Wait a minute. Is I'm on YouTube? Where is Rose at? Rose, can you say something, please? Where is your name at? There you go. Amy Peterson, can you email me, please? So I can get you your goodies. What's going on, Shawnee? Claire Bear, I will see you later. Sharon Renee, I will see you later. Studio, I love you. Rose, Silk, Shanice, Janice, brother. Y'all go on over there to 1Q Fat Boy. Y'all make sure y'all should subscribe to him as well. Silk. Yeah, it's 10. That's because you on the West Coast. I'm on the East Coast, girl. Tam, good night. Too Cute, Martin, y'all, good night. Good night. I love y'all. Y'all don't forget to like, comment. Y'all come back on the video after this, the live chat is gone, and comment and tell me how you enjoyed the show. Let me know where you're from. If you could just take a minute and say, hey, I'm in Texas and I love the show. Or, hey, I'm in Vegas. Hey, I'm in wherever you're at. Come back on the after this is done and let me know where you're at. Okay? So I love you guys. You guys know the saying, say it with me. Okay, say it with me. Love you, studio. Love you, Amy. Amy, email me. Y'all say it with me. Beauty is a state of mind, not body. My mind's stuck on gorgeous. What are you thinking? You know I want to know. Y'all go get your merch. Y'all, I love you. You guys have a wonderful night. And listen, don't forget what I said, Joseph. Don't forget. Love you.
Hey queens, I know we are all excited about the change in seasons. Bye-bye to the heat, y'all. Listen, I need you to go to www.thejoyamore.com. As we transition into the seasons, I want you to only be falling for one thing, and that is to fall in love with you. Use code FALL to save 15%. Love you. Hey queens, I know we are all excited about the change in seasons. Bye-bye to the heat, y'all. Listen, I need you to go to www.thejoyamore.com. As we transition into the seasons, I want you to only be falling for one thing, and that is to fall in love with you. Use code FALL to save 15%. Love you.